Then our thoughts to music now, because the greats of the jazz world are gathering in London tonight to mark an incredible achievement by an incredible man. Ivor Mairants has worked as a jazz musician and composer for more than 8 years. He's Britain's leading jazz guitar expert, and now he's detailed the history of jazz in a new book. We'll be talking to Ivor in a moment. First, let's hear some authentic jazz guitar from one of his former students, Esmond Selwyn. Some more from you later. Now, I'm holding a remarkable book which has been put together by Ivor over many, many years. It's The Great Jazz Guitarists. It weighs 8.5 pounds. Only 1,000 copies have been printed, and they've all been numbered to authenticate them, and this is number one. It's leather bound, it has a slip case, it's got gold leaf, it's got marbled end papers, and it's signed and numbered by the great man himself, and we're very pleased to have you on the programme. Tell me, first of all, if you're trying to summarise 50, 60 years of jazz, exactly what is jazz? What makes something distinctively jazz?
Well, first of all, it's improvised. You take a melody like you just heard, that is an improvisation on the melody, based on the harmony and melody of the piece itself.
Now, I hear a phrase very often from my musician friends called, that's a jazz chord. Are there chords that guitarists play only for jazz and in no other form of music?
Not really, because I'm using the jazz chord, so-called, in serious music. In sonatas that I've written to commemorate certain jazz players. But there are ways of writing, like Stravinsky, you can write Bach. Bach's chords are used very much in jazz.
So you can take a Bach harmony and improvise a jazz harmony out of it, or jazz melody out of it.
You'll get another third or another fifth or whatever.
Right. Now, you've spit this extraordinary book, which I gather is going to sell for £250, into five parts.
Yes.
The last of which is all about the great British jazz musicians.
That's right.
But one thinks instinctively of jazz as an American thing. Is that unfair on the Brits?
No, nothing is unfair. If you're good, you're good. If you're a great jazz player, you're a great jazz player. If you happen to be John McLaughlin, who is one of the great innovators of a new style of jazz, it's fine. If you happen to be Eric Clapton, who is an innovator of blues style...
So you put Eric Clapton into that list, would you?
I did. I put Eric Clapton in because I know that for some reason this English boy has imbibed the fundamental blues jazz of the cotton field. He doesn't care what chords he plays. Really doesn't. But what he plays can be
construed as that, and therefore it's in the book. Ivor, thank you very much. Congratulations on the book. Let's hope some people have got enough money to spend £250 on it.
I hope so. Is it cheap?
Historically cheap. Let's have some more jazz guitar now from Esmond. Esmond, play.
Thank you.
stuff. I could listen to that for ages. You're with Sky World News. Still to come, business report with Jeff.